Take a look at these highlights. All you see are the dunk shots. Yeah, whatever happened to the two-handed set shot? A real highlight, in my estimation, is a nice chest pass or a bounce pass. What's with those baggy shorts? You need a pair of suspenders to hold them up. When we played, we just had a slab of rubber on a canvas top, and that was it. Come on, chest pass, chest pass. Come on, Bob, think quick.
George.
You're going.
In the early days of the NBA, the Minneapolis Lakers' George Mikan faced his younger brother, Eddie, the center for the Chicago Stags. With friends and family looking on, George showed no brotherly love to Eddie, scoring on him at will and breaking his nose in the process.
After the game, we all went out and sat down and talking, and George's mother, she said, Georgie, why you beat up on your brother, Eddie? He says, Mama, if you'd have been out there playing, I'd have beat up on you too.
But for any team playing the Lakers, the message was, try to contain George Mikan. The NBA's first superstar dominated the league to the point where the rules were changed to make things actually tougher on him. Dolph Schayes of Syracuse had his own plan for stopping Mikan.
Mikan was probably the greatest player of that time. I tried to get in front of him. I try to push him out. I'm going to overplay him on the right side. I'll box him out. I did those things, and I held him to 42 points.
So you try it in a game. Harrison to Mikan. He's in the high pivot. And Slater Martin cutting away. Martin down the court. Over to Pollard. Harrison fires to Mikan.
Big boss man. Can't you hear me when I call? Big boss man. Can't you hear me when I call? Can't you hear me when I call? Well, you ain't so big. You know you're just tall, that's all. Hey, you got me working, boss man. Working around the clock. I want a little drink of water, but you won't let bigger stop, big boss man. Now can't you hear me when I call? I said you ain't so big. You know you just tall, that's all.
The comparative size of referee Ekman looks sort of like a midget.